This is the SAP Developer News for June 27th, 2024.
Hello, everyone. The open source community has significant milestone to celebrate, the 10th anniversary of abapGit. This remarkable journey began with initial commit in the summer of 2014 and has managed to pull the love and support of SAP community. Today, abapGit boasts an impressive status with 170 contributors and nearly 2 million lines of ABAP code shared through abapGit. You may have seen Lars, the founder of the project, featured in the recent Code Talk series. He commemorated the 10th birthday of abapGit with a special blog post. If you are interested in delving deeper into the abapGit client, which is written in ABAP, please head to the links in the description.
I've been around long enough to remember SAP's first contributions to open source, way back when. Contributions to the memory management area of the Linux kernel to allow R3 to run on Linux. It's hard to imagine a world without these two massively significant pieces of software, is it? Over the decades since, SAP has been a significant contributor to and consumer of open source software and ranks in the top 10 commercial contributors globally over on the Open Source Contributor Index. To reinforce the pledge that SAP has to open source principles and community engagement, SAP has published an Open Source Manifesto this month, a concise and to-the-point summary describing SAP's vision and commitment to open source. There's a PDF version of the manifesto available, but if you're like me and like to read things in a more open source context, of course you can go over to the manifesto repo on GitHub and read it there in lovely, plain, simple markdown. You can also find out lots more on the news article that was also published this week. Links, as always, are in the description.
I want to bring your attention to Jesse's blog. Doesn't that sound like an 80s rock song? Jesse is a product manager at SAP Build, and each quarter she writes a blog talking about all the new features from the previous 3 months. So she's talking about SAP Build code with its maiden release with Joule to create CAP applications, SAP Build work zone with new wizards to make creating workspaces easier, SAP Build Process Automation, which has a migration wizard to let you take your old RPA projects and bring them into Process Automation, as well as support for advanced event mesh. And SAP Build Apps, which has BTP authentication now enabled automatically in every project. In addition, it comes with a new set of flow functions that let you easily trigger processes from within your app. About Event Mesh, I recommend a series of videos produced by my colleague Antonio showing you how to easily set up eventing as well as to send those events to Process Automation. And on the triggering processes from Build Apps, I recommend a series of videos produced by myself that show you step-by-step how to trigger processes, get information about the instances, and more. I want to bring your attention to another blog by Eshbe about the pricing model of SAP Build Apps. There's been a change, and as far as I can see, the major changes are that you can now install SAP Build Apps on 3 tenants for the basic license so that you can create dev, QA, and prod environments. And there's been a vast reduction in the standard user license, standard users being the end users who use your apps. You will still need to obtain advanced user licenses for the people who produce the app. I will leave a link in the description to her blog as well as sap.com, where you can find very detailed information about the pricing model.
SAP HANA Cloud Q2 was released this week. It comes with a lot of new functionality. Just to mention, for example, Cloud Connector for SAP HANA Cloud Data Lake component, or ability to create virtual tables using SAP HANA deployment infrastructure. There are a lot of features as well in HANA embedded machine learning, and you can find a detailed blog with all the news posted. Or as well, you can read the blog post about all the new features in creating calculation views. Talking about SAP HANA, we are as well in the last week of our developer challenge for this month. And this week, on Wednesday, I published the new challenge. There you are working with some classic, I would say, already multimodal capabilities of SAP HANA, such as processing graphs and working with geospatial data.